You're trying to log in on a website to do some shopping. Email, password, right? But this time it isn't enough. They want more. A code that has been texted to you needs to be entered to complete the login. Sigh. I'm on my laptop, so now I need to get my phone out, check my messages, and then type in the code from my phone into the computer. While most of us can pass this off as a minor annoyance, for others it can make logging in impossible. People with limited motor control, low vision, or a cognitive disability may just be unable to log in. Let's talk about accessible authentication, new in WCAG 2.2. The key phrase you need to learn is cognitive function test. I know, welcome to WCAG. So what is a cognitive function test? You've likely seen plenty. These are things like puzzles, CAPTCHAs, calculations, memorization, and what we just described with the code on your phone you have to type into your laptop, that's transcription. Memorization, I hear you asking. Basic personal information such as name, email address, and phone number are fine, but requiring users to remember separate usernames, passwords, or things like secret answers are off limits. So what does it all mean? Well, it means you shouldn't have cognitive function tests as part of your login. If you're desperate for the loophole, know that AA allows CAPTCHA if it's only object recognition. But let's be honest, logging in without extra tests makes a better experience for everyone. Everyone deserves access to the internet. If you need help getting your website up to scratch, visit silktide.com.